Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to giving a demo on overcurrent relay testing system. So in this video, we are going to see how a power system and the other distribution system is protected by overcurrent condition using a IDMT type of overcurrent relay. The IDMT relay or the inverse definite minimum time relay is a time-dependent relay which behaves when the current is increased in a condition or any short circuit condition or any fault occurs in the distribution system, then it depends on the current value and how much time the current is increasing, and it behaves the inverse characteristics with a tripping time. In short, this is to be explained that when the current value in the overcurrent condition is increasing continuously, the tripping time of the relay will decreasing inversely, so that when the current value is very high, the tripping time is very low, which will be provided protection as per the time dependency, so that other of the system of the distribution system will be isolated properly, and if their current is due to any of the surge movement or any of the other false conditions or any of the load increment in the distribution, then this should be maintained as per the tripping value. So now in this video, we are going to create a same scenario of overcurrent by providing the current from a separate transformer of 270 volt AC, and this will be provided on the current coil of the IDMT overcurrent relay, and then we will increase the current carefully, gradually with the set point of the overcurrent relay, and when the current goes increase in the set point, the tripping time will also be marked with the timer presented in the system, and we will observe the characteristics of IDMT current relay with this. So now I will let you explain the complete circuitry and complete parts of this complete overcurrent system, and then we will later on perform the experiment of overcurrent and also optimize the IDMT overcurrent relay characteristics. So this is the overcurrent relay testing system, complete trainer board you are seeing on your front screen. The overcurrent relay monitors general balanced overloading and has current time settings. These settings determine the protective schemes. The relay is IDMT type, which has different tripping time and characteristics. So we will explain all the system one by one. So we have mains on off MCB here, so that you can turn on the off complete system with the 230 volt power supply. As you turn on the system, the general auxiliary power supply to the meters timer are provided directly, and the supply is in the system will be going through the variable power supply or variac connected over here. This is the auto transformer which we have as a variac, and output from 0 to 270 volts in the variable form is provided to complete circuit. And for understanding the role of relays in the real-time transmission system, here a circuit of transmission line is provided from source to distribution with the proper placing of all its required components, in which we will see the transmission line is continuously going through the circuit breaker. Then this is a tripping coil with connected with the overcurrent relay, and operating overcurrent relay will be also observed with this. Then the circuit breaker is connected to the transformer, and transformer is directly coupled with the distribution to the load. We will use a 40 volt bulb here at the 230 volt power supply, behaving like a load on this bulb holder, and which will be connected with the transformer installed in this. Then the 230 volt power supply is directly provided to the relay circuit over here presented. Then we use the voltmeter at this place. So voltmeter will be connected. This is a AC voltmeter to measure the voltage range from 0 to 300 volts. So we have a supply of 270 volt maximum. We can easily measure the supply with this AC voltmeter. Then this is the AC ammeter, so that we can observe the current passing through the relay coil, and which behaves the current, and current will be generally as per the setting and the time setting, current setting and the time setting described in the overcurrent relay testing system. Then we will connect a rheostat to adjust the current value. Rheostat of 110 ohm at 5 amperes value will be connected with this and also provided with the complete trainer board. Then connector for the circuit breaker supply is provided here. This will be directly going through the terminal of NO of the contactor inside. The contactor will be contactor behaving like the circuit breaker over here. So the circuit breaker will be connected when the supply is continuously on, and when the current will increase the set value of the IDMT, the NO terminal of the overcurrent relay will be changed to NC and open circuit will be happen, so that the circuit breaker will be open and load will be cut off from the complete transmission line. The current setting of the overcurrent relay can be done using a plug provided inside the current setting. We will unscrew the all bolts of this mechanical type overcurrent relay, in which the disc plate is provided here. So when the relay is picking up the current more than the current setting value, it will start rotating. We will observe this as well, and according to the current and time setting, we will set the plunger at any of the value from 0.5 to 2 amperes of the rating, so that we can set the value according to the current value setup of the overcurrent relay. Current will be seen on the AC ammeter, and we will set the current using rheostat appropriate value, and then we will see when the current is start picking up. As the relay starts picking up, we will turn on the time or the timer with this on off switch provided is here, so that time of the tripping will be noted down on the timer inside this. So this was the complete explanation of overcurrent relay testing system. I have explained all the parts. Now we move on to perform the experiment for overcurrent testing system. So rheostat and patch cords for connections are also provided with this complete system. These are also included in this, and we have also offering the user manual in which all the details and study about the protection of system, power system, distribution and transmission, and a detailed explanation about the overcurrent relay of IDMT type overcurrent relay, inverse definite time overcurrent relay, is given in the user manual. You can study with that as well. Now we will do the experiment on this to study the time current characteristics of the overcurrent relay. The basic circuitry or the schematic diagram is given over here, in which the auto transformer is directly coupled with a circuit of relay tripping, in which voltmeter and ampere meter is connected for the relay current, and rheostat is also connected and included in the line, so that we can adjust the current according to our value. So S1 and S3 are the relay switch terminal, so that open circuit condition will be overcurrent condition, lines will be directly sensed by the overcurrent relay, and system will be trip the circuit breaker with this. So the bulb and the distribution time load will be decreased and isolated from the complete transmission line. Rest of the connections are also given as per the panel diagram. We have to made up all the connection as described in this user manual, then we will observe and follow the procedure given in the user manual, so that we can easily perform and do the overcurrent tripping for this system as well. Now before doing the practical, make sure the earthing of your laboratory is proper and connected to the backside of the panel, and do not touch rheostat at the time of testing to avoid the shock. Always turn switch at position off when the relay trips, and auxiliary supply provided for the ammeter and voltmeter timer should be a separate transformer. Now we will start doing the connection as given in the user manual. For this, first make sure the supply, main supply, is in off condition. So our supply is in off condition right now. Now we will make the connections as given in the connection diagram. For this, we required patch cords of different sizes, which is given with the complete system and complete setup. So we'll start doing the connections. For this, first we will connect the phase and neutral of the variac supply to the input line. Then we will include the voltmeter and ampere meter to the system. For voltmeter, we will connect phase with the red wire and neutral with the black one. Now for adding the ampere meter in the system, we will connect this line with the ampere meter line. Now to adding the ampere meter at that point, connect red with the red terminal of the ampere meter and black with the black terminal of the ampere meter. Now in continuation, ampere meter will be connected to the rheostat line. Now we will add the rheostat in the system. So connect rheostat one point here and the other point at the second point of the rheostat. Now using a black patch cord, connect the other end of the rheostat to the switch, relay switch S1 as well, so that current will be directly start passing through the IDMT coil. Now these are the connection of the relay side, sorry, on the power supply side. Now we will do the connections. Just there is a connection one more remaining to provide the negative terminal on the S3 terminal as well. Now we'll do the connection from the other side. Now from the other side, we will connect the open circuit 2 terminal or the overcurrent 2 terminal to the black one, and we will connect the terminal to S3 as well. And this will be going passing through the SPDT switch provided inside, so that timer and relay will be combinedly connect with the trip coil and the circuit breaker. Now for the circuit breaker connections, the contact of the circuit breaker will be connected. So we will connect red one with the CB1, black one will be passing through the relay terminal, NO terminal, so that circuit breaker direct connection will be passing through the relay. Whenever the relay is energized and the tripping is occur, the NO contact of the relay will be changed to NC and our circuit breaker coil will be tripped and the circuit breaker will trip the system to the load. Now we will connect the load for this. Connect black to black and red to red. These are the output of the transformer. Now we will connect a 40 watt bulb on this bulb holder. So now we will connect the bulb to presuming a load which is connected with the transmission line at the bulb holder carefully. So this is our connections has been completed. Always verify your connection one time after before turning on the supply. Now we will unscrew the front panel of the IDMT relay, then we will set the plunger at a desired setting. I will explain you it in this video as well. Now for unscrewing the bolt, you just need to turn them to anticlockwise like this. The bolts are internally connected with the spring mechanism so that there will be not coming out from the panel. It will be internally placed here. After unscrewing all the bolts, you can see the panel is now open. So this blue point is the plunger of the IDMT overcurrent relay. We just need to set the plunger as per the desired value. You can see the value are marked on the lower side of the plunger as well. I will try to show you this closely. So these are the different current settings value in amperes given, and you can easily plug the plunger or plug inside any of the settings required. So we will start setting up with the 0 to 0.5 ampere setting. This is the second socket is for 0.5 to 0.75 current setting. Then this is at one current setting, and the graph of the time with the current is provided here. These are the plug setting multiplier graphs. So this will be behaving as per the IDMT overcurrent characteristics. Make sure you always do the connections and opening of the overcurrent relay panel in the off condition of the complete panel, so that you will do not harm yourself through the any electrical shock and hazardous conditions. After setting the plug to your desired value, just again cover the front panel with the plastic case so that you can easily perform the experiment without any hazardous condition and at the risk of getting shock. So I have covered my panel. Now we will start doing experiment as described in the user manual. Always verify your connections before starting the setup. I have verified my connections. Now I will turning on the supply using the MCB. So as I turn on the supply, you can see my load is now continuously working. The bulb is on right now, and all the values of voltage and current of the current coil is zero right now. So as described in the user manual, we will gradually increase the current up to 50 volt through the single phase variac. This is the inbuilt variac, so that we can easily increase the voltage at 50 volts through this. Similarly, current is also increasing in the AC ampere meter. We can observe that. So we'll increase the voltage, let us say for up to 50 volts. This will be enough for energizing the tripping coil of the overcurrent relay. So voltage has been set to 50 and current right now 0.43. You have to remember that we have set the current value for the overcurrent relay, which is about 0.5. So 0.5 ampere will be our maximum limit. So we need to set the current value up right now using the rheostat more than the current setting provided in the IDMT relay. So we have set the current value on the plunger setting of the plug setting is about 0.5, which is the maximum value for this. So we'll increase the current using the rheostat more than up to 150% for the starting instant value. So we'll increase the current up to 0.80, which is maximum about 150% of the setting value inside that overcurrent relay. So we have set the value about 0.82. when we turn on the relay, the sum of 0.1 milliamperes will be consumed by the relay coil, so that our setting value will be around 80. Just check the relay when the picking up of the relay starts. This will be your current value for this overcurrent system. So we have provided overcurrent to the setting value. Now we will turn on the switch and see how much time the relay will take to tripping. Here, as I turn on the relay, the current slightly drops and relay is energized and now starts rotating the disc, and the disc will be tripped the system in some time, and time will be also marked and stopped on the timer. We'll get the accurate time for the tripping the system. Here It is taking 33.9 seconds to tripping this at the current value of 0.76 for this relay system. After tripping the relay, just turn off the system, note down the timer value. Now for the next value, we will increase the current some more, and now we will see what time the relay takes to trip. Now after second taking the next reading, just make sure the timer should be at the reset position, starting position should be 0, and also you need to reset the relay. If you find the relay is not reset, the metallic probe is showing the trip condition with the red indication over here. Just press this from here so that it will close the red indication. So relay is right now reset. Now we again increase the time, sorry, the current up to 1 ampere, and we will see how much time with relay will take for this. In the last one, at the setting of 0.75, the relay has been taken about 33.9 seconds, about 34 seconds. Now for this value, we will see how much time the relay will taking. Again, I will on the system and see how much time relay is taking for this. So as our current value has slightly increased, so the tripping time should be decreased earlier as the earlier value. So here you can see the tripping time is right now 17.9 seconds, which is about 10 to 13 seconds quick response for this. So as the current value increase, the tripping time is decreasing. So this is how the relay is working. Now we'll take one more reading for more current value. Also, I will this time show you the relay movement from the close as well. Now again, after tripping, note down the value of time and current in the observation table. Press reset and off the relay. Again, we will press reset. Timer should be at 0. Now we'll increase the current up to 1.25 amperes. Now, as the current increasing in lower amount, the time will be decreased in the higher quantity. So we'll set the current about 1.25 ampere for this. So this is approximately 1.25 ampere. Timer is reset. Relay should be also reset. Now we will on the relay switch so that relay will be starts in action. So now I am going to again start the relay in action, and you will see the relay rotating disc and the observing picking up time should be now more less than from the earlier two readings. Here the relay is tripped. You can see load is disconnected as the circuit breaker tripped the relay, and this is the indications of relay tripping. Time taken in this system, as we increase the current up to 1.25, the time to taking the trip condition is about 12.2 seconds for this. So our time is continuously decreasing as we increasing the current value for the system as well. Now we again reset the relay. First, off the switch so that load will be again connected. Reset the relay by just pushing this switch upside and reset the timer as well by pressing this reset button. Now we'll take one more reading, this time up to 1.75 ampere. This is very high current for this setting, as our setting is about 0.5 ampere, so that the tripping time should be very minimum for this value. Now we again connect the relay in the system by turning on this switch, and at this time we will get very quick tripping time lower than rest of the other times earlier that we have taken. So this is the time taken, which is 8.7 seconds for this higher value of 1.54. As we have increased the current up to 0.75, but as the current value is increasing, the relay energize and relay consumption of the coil consumption current is slightly increased, so that our value should be taken is about 1.54 for this system. Now for some different current time multiplier setting, we can change the plug position again to any of the other setting, but before that, turn off the relay, reset the timer and place the variac at zero value and turn off the system. Now we will again unscrew the panel and set the time multiplier to different value. So I have unscrewed the panel and now pull the plug from the socket of 0.5 ampere and now we will set this to about 1 ampere setting for this relay. You can set up to 2 ampere, but for the quick result and quick response, you can get the medium value for this system. Now after picking up the front panel of the relay by a screw bolt, then we again follow the same procedure. For this, do not need to change any connections, just need to change the current value for this as well. Make sure before starting the experiment, your stud should be at maximum position so that no excess of amount current will be flow inside the coils, so that relay will not damage. Now again turn on the MCB. This time we will increase the current up to 60 ampere or 60 to 70 volts, as we require the current, and the setting of the current from the rheostat should be in the range so that we can easily perform the experiment to according value. So this time we'll increase the current up to 70 volts, increase the voltage up to 70 volts. So we are getting 0.60 current right now, but our setting is 1 ampere for this, so we'll increase the current some more so that from the rheostat we do not need to require the ranging value more than that. So this is approximately 0.8 current to the relay is passing, so we can easily increase the current right now with this rheostat. Make sure relay should be at the reset position properly. Now again we will increase the current and same procedure will be happen. We'll match the relay picking up time and the tripping time as well. So I will again increase the current more than 1 ampere, which is our set value for the relay. So we'll set the value about 1.25 ampere, 25% more from the setting value, and turn on the relay switch and see whether the relay is picking up or not. So at this value, relay is not picking up. So we'll again reset the timer and increase the value of current up to 150% for this. So we have increased the value about 1.6 ampere, which is 60% more than the setting value. Now again, I will turn on the relay switch and relay starts picking up, and we'll observe how much time it will take to trip. So system has been tripped in 34 seconds from the current value of 1.58 for this system. You can note down both the values, tripping time and picking up current on the observation table. Now for some next reading, we can again reset the system, reset the relay as well, and reset the timer. Now again increase the current up to 1.8. or 1.9 amperes, which are 90% more than the set values. And again we will see what time it will take to trip. The time this time should be lower than the earlier value. Now again we will start the system and see how much time relay taking to trip the system. So this has been taking 19.2 seconds for this value. So note down the current, picking up current and trip time for the observation table. By taking these types of reading, 2 to 4 readings for different types of settings, you can plot a graph of picking up current versus tripping time, and you will get the complete characteristics of the IDMT inverse definite time minimum time relay. After taking all the readings and after doing your complete experiment, make sure the relay should be in off condition. Reset the relay once and decrease the voltage first using the variable supply auto transformer and turn off the system through the MCV, so that all the system and commands should be in proper zero voltage and zero value, and there should be no hazardous condition occur whenever you on the circuit next time. So that's how we perform the complete experiment on the overcurrent relay testing system, in which we have also understand how the load is controlled and protected through the overcurrent relay as the circuit breaker is tripped when the relay sends the overcurrent, and the tripping time versus tripping current value characteristic also have been observed through this practical. So about detailed explanation about the IDMT relay and different protection system, you can use the user manual, in which all the details about the power system protection and the overcurrent relay and overcurrent fault conditions are given. You can easily study the complete setup by studying this user manual with this. And I have always tried to do the complete explanation and complete clearing of the concept of your by working with the practical information with that. And I hope you will get the proper information and proper technical details about how the system is working, how we control the overcurrent with the relay system provided with this kit. So if you like the video, please press the like button, and you can also share the video with your colleagues, classmates and your fellows to getting the information about that, those who are want to learn about this type of system. You can also refer and subscribe our channel to the system, and you can also subscribe our channel, which is Tesca Tech on the YouTube. There are a lot of videos about this type of concepts for the practical information are uploaded for different details, and you can also press the bell button so that whenever we get the new video and upload the new video, you will get the proper notification about that as well. Till then, thanks for watching this video. We'll meet in the next video.